Climate Change and the Syrian Civil War, a presentation based on the ECC Factbook. More than 220,000 people dead, countless more wounded, and no end in sight. The situation in Syria is dire. Since protests started in March 2011, the conflict has intensified to become one of the worst in recent decades. Until today, it has caused almost half of the population to flee their homes. The direct causes of the Syrian crisis relate to popular discontent with the authoritarian regime of Bashar al-Assad. Yet, a number of experts have highlighted the roles of climate change, drought, and poor resource management as additional factors behind the Syrian crisis. In fact, the Syrian case offers important insights into how environmental factors can feed into popular grievances and, in combination with other social factors, produce widespread violence and suffering. The following analysis is based on the conceptual model identifying possible links between the conflict in Syria and climate change. Over the past decades, the Mediterranean littoral zone and the Middle East have warmed up considerably, leading to an intensification of drought cycles. Of the 12 driest winters hitting the region since 1902, 10 have occurred in just the last 20 years. According to a study from the US National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, NOAA, this change towards drier conditions cannot be explained by natural variability alone. Anthropogenic greenhouse gases and aerosol forcing, as well as increases in sea surface temperature, are major contributing factors as well. A particularly serious drought hit the region between 2006 and 2010. In Syria, the consequences were disastrous, especially in the northeastern part of the country. As a consequence of crop failures and plummeting livestock numbers, an estimated 2 to 3 million people were driven into extreme poverty. The impact of drought was compounded by the unsustainable water policies that the Ba'ath Party government has implemented for years. To win public support, it pursued overambitious agricultural projects, provided subsidies for water-intensive crops and inefficient irrigation methods, and turned a blind eye to unsustainable patterns of water consumption, including thousands of unlicensed black wells. As a consequence, local aquifers have been decreasing at an alarming rate. The Syrian government's actions and emissions thus played a significant role in increasing water scarcity. These environmental and social causes had several direct effects. Droughts and water scarcity caused a loss of livelihoods and a scarcity in survival resources. By 2011, the droughts had left an estimated 1 million Syrian civilians in extreme food insecurity. This resulted in a large exodus of farmers and herders to urban areas, thereby increasing competition for housing, jobs, and access to services. A shock in food prices stirred nationwide unrest. People became increasingly upset with the government, which did little to address their desperate situation. Besides a rift between the people and their government, the situation also brought about grievances between different societal groups. These dynamics played out in a particularly volatile political context. Before 2011, many Syrians already held strong grievances against the Assad regime relating to political oppression and corruption, and the example of revolutions in other Arab countries was obviously important in triggering the original protests in Syria. These grievances largely resulted from biased agricultural policies. From 2000 on, the Assad regime had favoured the expansion of private agribusinesses held by a small group of elite supporters and had lifted important subsidies for smallholders. Furthermore, when drought conditions hit the country in 2006, the government was quite reluctant in assisting the drought-stricken population and even in acknowledging the gravity of the situation, which strongly contributed to popular discontent. In fact, the droughts played a proximate role in exacerbating structural political problems, without which the Syrian crisis would probably not have reached its actual proportions. The international community has repeatedly attempted to negotiate peace. Yet, these efforts have so far failed in the face of seemingly incompatible positions by the warring parties and some of their outside backers. Several donors provide funds to UN humanitarian operations in order to address the basic needs of the population. However, these remain underfunded, although this may improve as the European Union seeks to stem the tide of Syrian refugees fleeing to Europe. To resolve the environmental dimension of the Syrian civil war, many other conflict resolution measures will be necessary. Most of these can, however, only be initiated once the violence of the conflict abates. One crucial element will be the diversification of the Syrian economy, with a view to lessening the importance of the agricultural sector, combined with stronger social safeguards. Likewise, improving the water infrastructure and water management will be an essential factor. All measures would need to be accompanied by a stronger legal framework, increased cooperation, the cessation of violence, and a general increase in state capacity. Overall, the situation has dramatically deteriorated since 2011. The emergence of ISIS has further complicated the conflict, as has the increasingly direct intervention of regional and great powers. Millions of refugees and migrants represent a major challenge for countries neighbouring Syria and beyond. And there is no end in sight for the suffering of the Syrian population. Much is yet to be done to resolve the conflict. This analysis, as well as all graphs and data shown, are available at factbook.ecc-platform.org. The ECC Factbook is an online tool designed to inform both policymakers and the general public about conflicts with an environmental dimension. It provides case studies, infographics, analysis, and data on over 100 environmental conflicts worldwide.